Hi everybody, Jim Meskimen here with your Impressions lesson. Hey, first of all, Happy New Year. It's 2015, and this is my first Impressions lesson in Impressions by me, Jim, Impressions lesson of the year. So, hi! First great thing that I have to report on, and you probably already found out, is my good buddy and partner of the Impression guys, Ross Marquand, has landed a series regular role on The Walking Dead. So that's pretty awesome. He's a great actor, so it's not a big surprise. Plus, he's pretty tasty. I mean, his flesh. I took a bite out of him, when was that? A few months ago. I think it's healed now. And not bad. Out of his arm. Don't get ideas. So I hope you've been working on your impressions all the last few months that I haven't been giving you lessons. I hope you've caught up by now. There's a lot of things to look at. We looked at, first being the character, just sort of deciding without making any noise at all, you know, what does this character feel and look like? And all that. So you probably graduated from that on to thinking about the musicality of the voice and pitch and rhythm and all that kind of thing of the people you want to imitate. And now we got a whole bunch of new Oscar nominees, too, that came out today. So that's pretty exciting. Benedict Cumberbatch, who I have not really started to work on. And he's actually, Benedict Cumberbatch is quite an impressionist himself. He changes his vocal dynamics quite readily. And so he's a tough one. Bradley Cooper plays this kind of buttoned up guy, an American sniper. Steve Carell, he's up for things. So all these guys, you know, if you're going to start to work on people that are sort of in the news and are all hashtaggy, then these are guys to work on. One thing I wanted you to think about today, if you're looking at doing some impressions and analyzing what it is about voices that you like. Picture in your mind when you hear a performer playing a certain character, what might visually that stream of communication from them look like? You know, if it was all a series of dots and dashes, or if it was like even a waveform kind of line, what would that look like? And would it come in short bursts?
You know, like Tommy Lee Jones sometimes spits things out. Little tiny chunks. Robin Williams, of course, we remember quite famously, would have a whole freight train full of thoughts that would come by all at once and then stop. Oh, they'd have to stop because of all the laughing. Still miss Robin. Or Morgan Freeman, who famously just lays back and lets the words come forth like a never-ending stream of beautiful vocal syrup.
You know, so take a look at that. What would that look like from the people that you're imitating or that you want to look like?
Christopher Walken, for example. Strange pattern. Very weird. A lot of dots and dashes. Some strange symbols we don't understand.
But picture that in your mind, because that's kind of a key to the musicality, if you will, of a particular performer.
Jack Nicholson also. He would lay back and kind of push things forward like this and take a lot of pleasure and delight in everything he said.
Even helps maybe to doodle, draw a little picture of it for yourself. And that will distinguish it from other voices that you do, including your own voice, you know. You might even listen to your own voice and see, you know, what is that really, you know, when you lay out your voice to people, how are they receiving it, you know? Is it in little fits and starts? Or you talk real fast and then back off? Or are you kind of a slow, a little more lugubrious, a little more careful speaker? You know, maybe do you go up at the end like a lot of people do, this kind of upspeak? Which is called terminal ascension, I was told by Andrea Romano, which I think is a really great word. Actually, two words. We'll have good news about the Impression guys soon, and this great news about Ross Marquand is really very buoying. Very buoying. In fact, I'm floating around like a buoy right now. Well done, Ross. Well done. So I'll have more lessons for you soon. This is just a little thing. I basically just wanted to say Happy New Year, and I hope you're still working on your impressions.
And your homework assignment this week is to talk in a high cartoony voice for 5 minutes.